Foreign Affairs has now joined in the campaign to shore up the country's tourism industry by way of marketing using missions and embassies abroad.
As Foreign Affairs, I think we thought if we get about 2-3 billion shillings this year, we can then leverage with our partners attendance exhibitions. This is a Hikurian task. So if we can work together, I'm sure we can overcome it.
Mugume, the permanent secretary, made this disclosure while receiving a delegation of leading tourism firms from Canada, currently on a week-long visit to Uganda's national parks and other sites.
And I'm here to host and escort a group of travel agents from Canada and the USA around Uganda. And we're here to experience the culture, the wildlife, the bird life, and the people of Uganda.
We don't get many Canadians coming to Uganda, which I have never understood why. So now, with the efforts of the Ministry of Tourism, with UTB, UTA, the Ugandan Embassy in Canada, this is the first real effort to bring Canadians here, and it's wonderful.
And a swift reaction of industry players to this development is that the move would consolidate the planned arrivals following the unveiling of the single tourist visa at this year's tourism fair in Berlin, Germany.
As you know now, our foreign missions are moving away from the traditional diplomacy. They are now doing commercial diplomacy. They are promoting trade, tourism and investment. So we feel this is a wake-up call for many others, and we give them credit for this kind of initiative.
And we hope that by inviting powerful people from the tourism industry in Canada to come and see by themselves, they bring back a positive image about Uganda. So basically, we want to attract as many tourists as possible.
Reina Ojun, NTD.